I'm Dennison, creator of Marine Diesel Basics, the first visual guide to marine diesel systems. In this video, we'll explore the diesel fuel circuit, from the deck fuel filler all the way through to the return line from the injectors. Thanks for watching. The fuel circuit of a diesel engine starts with a fuel filter funnel, which is an inexpensive way to keep water out and contamination out that may already be in the diesel from the supplier. The deck fuel filler, which also may be installed in the floor of the cockpit, should be kept tightly closed and the O-ring in good condition. There are specific standards for diesel fuel hoses, depending where the hose is routed, in the engine room or not. Never use cheap polyester hose for fuel hoses. Fuel tanks can be built of stainless steel, aluminium, fiberglass, polyethylene or black iron. If practical, a drain is useful for removing free water and contamination from the bottom of the tank. The larger the primary fuel filter, the better, because the longer it will take to plug up if contamination is stirred up in rough waters. The lift or transfer pump draws fuel from the tank through the primary fuel filter to the engine and pushes the fuel through the secondary fuel filter to the injection pump. The secondary fuel filter should be 2 or 5 microns. It's intended to catch the smallest particles. This is the last defense before the injection pump. The injection pump pressurizes the diesel. In mechanical injection pumps, such as this one, it also controls the firing of the injectors. The high pressure lines are usually made of steel. Pressures can be up to 25,000 psi on common rail diesels. Always use 2 wrenches or spanners when loosening or tightening the flare nut to avoid the danger of twisting the lines and kinking them. Injectors atomize the diesel and fire it into either a swirl chamber or directly into the cylinder. Injectors on electronic diesels are controlled by the engine's computer. The return or leak-off line returns excess diesel to the fuel tank. The fuel gauge or dipstick to dip the tank is taken for granted, but is really part of the fuel circuit. Without it, it's almost impossible to accurately know how much is in the fuel tank. So a quick recap. The fuel filter, the deck fuel filler, proper hoses, the inbuilt fuel tank, primary filter, lift pump or transfer pump, secondary fuel filter, injection pump, injector lines, injectors, the return line, and finally the fuel gauge or a dipstick. Well, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and share, and head over to the Patreon page. For as little as $3 a month, you could help me put subtitles in multiple languages on these videos. And until next time, I wish you fair winds and a reliable diesel.